Welcome, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's the 275th day of Making Songbringer, and today I'm working on some more input refinements, stuff that I realized by watching people play the game in person at Indie Cup last week. And yesterday, worked on getting the buttons so they can show up as like Xbox buttons. So, for example, right now, if you watch the A, B, X, Y buttons down on the bottom HUD, and I start using the Xbox controller, it immediately switches the icons to Xbox icons. And so I want to refine the artwork for those icons today. I want to make some icons for PlayStation controllers as well. What up, Pedro? And also I want to put on these item screens right here. Whenever you pick up a new item, it'll show you what button to use to use it, and also what button to use to get to the to remap it, or you go to your inventory. So yeah, just part two of that, and hopefully I'll be done with that today. And you know, this is also if I start using like my keyboard again, it switches back to the other icons. So if I use Xbox, it does those icons. Keyboard does the others. Also, that's one more thing I got to do today is make these keys actually show the keyboard keys you would use. So instead of it being A, B, X, Y, mine would be F, D, S, and G. Just like Vim keys, but on the other hand. What's up, Red Sands? Wait a minute. Why didn't I watch that one? Oh, that's right. You sent me a Twitter link. Let me go right. I forgot to get that and actually check it out. I checked out all the other videos yesterday.
I want to introduce someone who's going to introduce our keynote speaker. I want to bring up Alex Rosenberg. He's the manager of Platform.
What's up, Alex Pita? What's up, Protito? Alex Pita. Ciao. Okay. First up, I wanted to show the icon for the button that you would use to use the item. So for example, for picking up the bomb item, it would show you that, oh, you're gonna use the letter, you're gonna use the A button. Pick this up. So at the bottom of this text right here, I want this it to say, you know, letter A or B or X or Y or whatever. Use item. So the window needs to be a little bigger. And it scales to 1.0 there. So actually the size, lines.size, hyper. We're also gonna need an additional size for the window. Plus maybe, I guess hyper times another one. Lines.size plus 2.5. So yeah, 3.5 here. So that should give us one more line for putting in some more information here on this little window. Yeah, so if you guys just joining, I'm working on stuff that I got to watch people play the game in person last week at Indie Cup, and it really, really gave me a lot of ideas for how I can make the game less, more self-explanatory. You know, I shouldn't have to be there talking over someone's shoulder, trying to, you know, help them understand the game. And it's not that they need help understanding, it's just that it takes everyone a moment or two to get used to it and know what buttons to use and know that, for example, the select button brings up the inventory. So those little things are things that should just be more self-explanatory. So there, we got enough room here for another line. Now we can add the instructions. So we're gonna grab the image. First of all, we need to look through the player. Basically, we need to find the button that we would use. For this thing. So what it's equipped to. So it automatically equips right before we call this function here. So we need to look now, just look through all the gear component equipables, looking for this item. So we'll loop over the number of equipables. E.gear.equip I is equal to the item. What's the item again? Got this variable stored somewhere. I think it's transition item. Let's see if that's right. Transition. No, flux item? Maybe I think it's flux item. Yeah, there we go. Flux item. So we'll call this equip index, set it to -1 at first. That's invalid. So if we find it, we're good. And we can go equip index equals I and break. There, now we've got the equip index. So if the equip index is greater than or equal to 0, we can go ahead and add this icon. So we'll get the icon, and that's area get, what was that function we added yesterday to get input type something? I forget. Look for it. Input type. No, it's not that, huh? Oh, it's game scene. That's why. Game scene. Here we go. Set input type. Get input type. Set input type. And where's it? Other? Here we go. Get input type image. Get input type image from the input type, which is in set input type. Oh yeah, set input type is also from inputs. Input has a method for that. So input, current input type is input get input type. And the button index, K button A plus equip index. There. Okay, so now we got a file name. We create a sprite. Parent is going to be window C1. There's another sprite method though I can use that's way more. We got file name, pixel, pause, anchor. Pause is, I'm not sure yet. Let's do back to depends on if we, well, we have the instructions guaranteed. So be the like the window size, half the window. So we got a window size right there. Maybe we want to go negative or just size dot width times negative a half or so, and then it's going to be see if add text modifies p. No, it doesn't. Minus equals hyper. So here we can go p dot y minus equals hyper times lines dot size. And then we can use p.y for the position, and then vec2, 0.5. I think that's all we need. Color is an optional. It's missing something. Frame, file name, pixel, pause, anchor. Frame is null pointer. File name, pixel, pause, anchor, parent. C, color. See if it could pause without the color, though. What's up, Pete and Wally? Oh. How you doing? Evening. All right. Let's see if we got that icon. Yeah, this is part two of this of yesterday's stuff, so making it so now when I use the Xbox controller, it switches to Xbox icons. And when I go and pick up something, I want it to show the Xbox icon right there. So at the bottom, I've got some space there at the bottom of this window now. I want to show, use the B button to, or X button to place these bombs. And press select if you want to use your see your inventory. So I want that little bit of, little tiny bit of explanation. Not too much tutorialness, but like, no, still helping the player to explain the game just a tiny bit, you know, so people don't have as much of a hard time playing it. Okay, so that didn't work. I want to figure out why. Equip index looks like, oh, I didn't find it. Well, let's see, on Tristan, there's gear system pickup item. It should have already equipped the item. E gear auto equip item K on a bomb. Oh, it's the wrong item. Okay. This kind of sucks that I have to put a special case here. What I think I do. So the item is the flux item. And if gear component is bomb container item, item equals K, item bomb. One special case so far. Because it's only one special case, I'm allowing this. If it were two special cases, then I'd start thinking of a better system. So now we should have that working. Let's see. I go pick up this item. It should now at least have the button that you need to use. No. What happened? Equip index 2. All right, it worked. Okay, so it worked that time, but must have just have the wrong. Oh, even got the right image. Looks like the sprite then is the problem. See, they're not putting it in the right. Oh. That's the problem. I think it's the position dot Y. Wait, this is when it adds text. It's either the X or the Y. So one of these is wrong. So I'll try P.X first. Just wondering why this icon doesn't show up. There we go. Nice. So I need the words like X dash use and then select dash inventory. Okay. So the thing is, if there is an equip index, I want the equip button and the select button. If there is no equip index, it's just the select button. So the select button is going to be centered, or the select button is going to be offset. So it's a conditional case on its position, which means that. I guess we'll just do the first case first. Yeah, so let's put this minus a bit and then add a kit label. I'll try the small font. And we need to create a string for this. So I'm going to call this one menu use. And inventory. So this is going to be game get localized string menu item use position. P.x minus a little bit. We got pixel. Okay. Let's try 15 pixels for that. And then this one's maybe 25 pixels. We use the WTF method for ascertaining where this should be. Z should be 1. Okay, so now we should at least have the word use somewhere on the screen, probably not in the right positions. And then we'll add the conditional case for adding the select where it should be. Okay, so the X needs to go a little farther back. And probably even farther. All right, so to make this easy, I'm gonna put the button with its anchor to the right, and the text with its anchor to the left, so that we can basically use the same position for both of them. Maybe like 35 pixels. Looks like we don't even need the word use. Or, I mean, doesn't need the word, the dash right next to use. It's kind of self-explanatory. Just put an X there. For some reason, it's lining up the bottom. Totally wrong. This could be like 40, this could be 30, perhaps. And I don't know why we need to add some to this other one. What's up, Ziri? It's going good, man. How about yourself? Right on. Just finishing up the input refinements that I started yesterday, making it so you can see the buttons for the actual controller you're using. Like, we got Xbox buttons here. Also gonna be PlayStation buttons, all that. All right, good. We're getting a little closer. It looks like we need to add a little more space between these. What's up, Scottish Pizza? So the screen does need one more half a line. So total of 4 lines there. And then once we get to the instructions part, we want to add half of a line. So hyper times lines dot size plus a half. And then, this use was up a little too high that time. They looked like they were a tad bit too spread out. Maybe that should be 38. This should be like 32. Let's see what that looks like. See it going up one more pixel on the font. And next we just need the select button. So you've been looking at the Songbird website? Would there be additional fees? I don't think so. I don't think Humble Bundle charges additional fees. And I don't know. Oh, right. Okay, so it probably depends on what form of payment you use. Oh, so it doesn't, Pedro, but what form of payment did you use? Because I think there's several of them, right? Oh, you do? So what do you use when you actually do a Humble Bundle payment or purchase? Like, do you use PayPal, your credit card, or Amazon, or something else? Bitcoin. I think Scottish pizza depends on this, but I don't know. Sorry, I wish I had a better answer than that. Okay, now I need some select icons. What the heck does a select icon? Oh, start and select. Wow. They're little black icons with triangles pointing one way or the other. What's up? Why Viso? Sorry, I don't know how to say your name. Let me correct me if I'm wrong about that. Please let me know how to say your name. The Indie Cup was really great. It was awesome. It was really great to hang out, get to lo know so many other great indie developers, and it was awesome watching people play the game in person. And it was amazing getting chosen as the audience choice and getting to present the game on stage. And it was awesome almost winning the $10,000. Almost so close. All right, so we got the X use button, and in fact, it gave me so much feedback on how to make the game better. Like, for example, now I'm adding it, so there's little tiny instructions. Whenever you pick up a new item, it shows you how to use it, or it shows you where you would go to use another item. Yeah, totally. It is totally incredible what Songwinger achieved. I'm really, really excited for that. And yeah, and also it reminded me to focus on what's important too. You know, like what's important is you guys, people that are interested in this game genuinely, that really want to play this game. Because what's at a small indie competition like that, there wasn't really that many people. So the way it works is, you know, the audience for Songbringer for this exact game is pretty small, right? In fact, for almost every indie game, it has a pretty small target audience. Like, I'm guessing maybe 1 or 2% of players are going to be interested in a particular indie game, no matter how great that indie game is, right? So it's not like you're just going to go to something like Indie Cup and find your playership. That's ridiculous. You know, if there's only a few thousand people at a little event, there's gonna be maybe 10 people that are even the type of people that would like your game, you know? So it just taught me that, you know, I need to focus on what I'm doing already. Do all these live streams, all the development already, and the way I've been sharing the game and building a following is working great. That was an awesome validation to just realize that, okay, I'm doing it right. You know, this is cool. I'm doing it right. And it also showed me that there's other people out there that need help too with how to do it right. Because they're not really like, you know, they haven't found their following. They haven't validated that their product is worth something people will buy. There's a lot of other, you know, business I would call mistakes that people are making out there. And man, it just, you know, it hurts to see people make those mistakes, but they gotta learn somehow, you know. Like Eves. Is it Eves? That right?
Yves Saint Laurent. Yves Saint
Oh, Eves. All
Laurent.
right. Oh, Eve. Just Eve? All right, Eve, gotcha. Okay, man, awesome. All right, next thing, I want to add a few more little buttons. In fact, I'm on the fence on whether I should do bigger buttons. In fact, I think I should. I should try some bigger buttons here. Because right now, the buttons are a tad bit small when you're there on that screen. And there, I guess they could be also be one more pixel bigger, and it would be nice. So yeah, I'll experiment with some bigger pixels and adding a select icon and all that. Okay, so graphics mode, transform. Gotta make sound effects. That makes everything better. All right, so I'm gonna experiment with 1 pixel bigger on the width and height of these icons here, which will give me a centered icon. Which will allow the text in the middle of the icon to be centered. I do believe this is all checked in. Yeah, I already know this is checked in. Good. Okay, so I've got that backed up as well. If I'm not happy with this change, I can easily revert. All right, so we're looking at button A first. What do these actually, this font look like? Oh yeah, the A is kind of tall. Tall and skinny. So that's a little more accurate. Maybe even that. No. Okay. That ought to do for button A. Button B. Must have got the wrong one. This is button X. That is Y, and this one's B. All right, B is was one of the biggest problems of all the letters. So now it looks all right. There's X and Y. Y! All right, so now going back to this white text here. What was your first ever game? You mean that I programmed? If you're talking about games I programmed, it was an old game. Back in 1995, it came out. It's called Adventures with Chickens. It was about chickens in space. They're just random chickens, just floating in space. And your mission is to save them from asphyxiation. Right? It was probably one of the most sophomoric ideas I ever come up with. It was ridiculous. But I was 14 years old. You got to give me some slack. It was horrible, man. And I'm sad that I lost the code to it. I would really like to go back and look at the funny code I wrote when I was 14 years old. In fact, it was horrible code. It was really, really bad. It was all in one single file. It was written in the C language. So it was C written all in one file. We're talking thousands of lines of game code all in one file. And I wrote it all in MS-DOS Edit. You know what I mean? It was just one of those things where I used the tools I had at the time, and that's all I had was MS-DOS Edit. Which is not really the IDE of choice I would give to anyone. So, you know, I would be hacking away, editing the file, close that out, compile, run the game. Okay, now there's a mistake. I got to go MS-DOS Edit, open up the file, go to the line that I'm thinking of, fix some code, save the file, exit out, compile, run the game again. That's how bad it was back then. Dude, people that are writing games today have it so easy compared to then. And yeah, there were IDEs back then, but I couldn't afford one. Sounds better than half the stuff you can find on the App Store. Perhaps. Okay, let's see what that looks like with one more pixel. Are these icons a little bigger this time? Actually, did it even compile them? Repack them? No, it didn't repack just yet. It's like, it just loves to repack the textures over and over because it does it every time it notices one file different and it noticed like four files different there. It's a little script I wrote in Hammerspoon to repack textures. It's supposed to save me time, but now it's really not saving me that much time lately. Okay, so I start walking north. Yeah, that's a little better with the little bit bigger icons, even down there. Yeah, I like that. And then picking up the item. Yeah, we've got a little, okay, there it is. 9 pixels instead of 8. Definitely worth that. That move. Okay, so we've got X is use it. And now it can go down 1 pixel, actually. Nah, maybe not. Okay, so now we need a little select icon and a start icon. Which are like these things. They're kind of squashed looking in this picture right here. They're not squashed looking in real, are they? They are a little bit squashed looking in real life. Oh wow, I never noticed these buttons were slightly oval like. Wow. Select and start on the Xbox controller. Totally ovals. Sort of egg shaped almost. Okay, so let's grab these. Bafu! What's up, Boogie? Howdy, howdy, man. So I want this to be a width of 9 pixels. That's our beautiful. It's so beautiful to be 9 instead of 8. This thing's now 9 by 8. But we want it to be 9 by 9, but it doesn't matter. We can delete some of these corner pixels. It's going good, man. How do you handle multiple resolutions? Is that necessary on PC? Yes, it is, man. How do I handle it? I'm going to add extra content for the ratios that are slightly different, but most ratios are very close to widescreen these days, so I've designed the whole game to be pretty widescreen friendly. However, there are certain ratios, like for example the iPad, which just mess it all up. The iPad's ratio is way different than widescreen. It's way more old school, like the 1.333 ratio, and it's 4x3, and it's just way different than widescreen. And basically, I have to develop some extra content to go on the edges of stuff for just the iPad or other resolutions. You just need to be very, Eve, you got to be real flexible with your games these days. You got to design your game completely resolution independent. Doesn't matter what game you're writing. Unless you are absolutely certain that you're only going to release on one platform and that that platform only has one resolution, which is almost unheard of today. So, yeah, it's going good, but you just phase two of this, the input refinements from yesterday. Scottish Peace, will this be Xbox 360? Well, I can't say at this point. I can't promise anything. However, I'm trying to get the game on Xbox and PlayStation. I'm simply designing this for the PC right here. And the PC, you can use your Xbox 360 controller. You can also use PlayStation controllers on the PC and Mac and Linux. So I'm designing the game from a pretty agnostic standpoint of using any kind of input and being very clear. So if a person's using that type of controller, I want the buttons to show those kind of buttons. Tom Peach, man, what's up? Welcome to stream. I was reading your Q&A. I was wondering if you have a picture of your setup. Yes, I do. I released it a while ago on Imgur Wizard Foo Battle Station. Let's see if we can find that. I tried posting it to Battle Stations on Reddit, but they deleted me. They're like, oh, you can't do that if you're not an actual PC. If you're some, because my computer's a laptop, they deleted me off Battle Stations. Imgur.com maybe, and then go to my own profile. Damn it, I'm logged out. Let me see if I can just get you an image from my computer, wherever it is. Here it is. This is kind of what my setup looks like right now. Only, so you can see I have like a, I have my graphics tablet I use, keyboard, mouse. I've got an Xbox controller right now, right here. And my iPad's up here, which I look at to do, you know, the chats and stuff like that. But yeah, this is basically what my setup's like. I put my laptop up on a closet shelf so that I'm looking really high and I can stand up and keep my back good and stuff. And it also is really excellent for having so many different things I need to use. Like if I got my graphics tablet down here, I got room for that. You know, I've got room for an Xbox controller as well and every other type of little device I need to do this type of development live. Okay, so getting back to here, let's reduce the colors. Don't need that. Looks Spartan, nice. Yeah, I'm a pretty Spartan person. I'm very much a minimalist. Do I think having a standing setup is better than a seated one? Not necessarily. I switch between both all day. Like I'll stand up for a few hours, I'll sit down for a few hours, and I'll rotate. And if you look at some of the research that's out there, I don't think either one is better than the other as far as your actual physical body. Sometimes you need to do sit down, and it's good to get your blood moving in a different way, you know, by sitting down. And sometimes it's really good to stand up. So it just kind of depends. Whatever's better for you. I think, you know, personally, I love switching. I love being able to stand up or sit down. Nice. You can't wait till Christmas because you're getting a sweet new processor and a dope laptop. Right on. That's completely awesome. So there, the reduce the colors on this thing. Are people going to be able to even tell that this is a select icon? I guess I'll put some white on top of it to show that it's this icon. Here's button select. I'm gonna just get the other icon as well. It's like before I do some white text, I'll do a little bit of white right there showing that it's the left arrow, which is kind of what the icon looks like. All right, so I'm going to resize this thing down to 9. Reduce its colors after I delete a few pixels. It's kind of weird that these are ovals, because I know this is going to create some alignment issues with these other buttons. I think I might cheat and make these actually not even ovals anymore. Yeah, let's do that. Is that a guitar? Yes, it is. There's a couple guitars over there. There's an acoustic and an electric. I love playing guitar, and for a whole year, I could not play guitar. That was this year. So I finally have healed my wrist. I had this whole tendonitis issue for a long, long time. This left side of my left hand. So I finally healed it. I was eating way too many eggs and peanut butter and meat. And all that stuff depletes your body of minerals. So I finally read some books and realized what was going on with my body. My body was not healing this issue. And finally I'm healed, dude. It's so great. I can finally play guitar again. It's awesome. I can climb trees again. I can do yoga again and stuff. It's freaking awesome. I can use the left shift key again. That's awesome. But I don't. I've now got a habit where I never ever use the left shift key. So I probably will stay that way for a while. All right, let's put a pop of white on top of these. Nice. You have 10 guitars? Whoa. Dude, that's awesome. Cool. What kind of guitar do you love to play? Or what's your favorite guitar? Personally, I love Gibsons. So it's like if that's my dream guitar, I wish I had a Gibson. What's up, PMC? Welcome, man. Okay, so we're ready to do these as layer-based slices. There's a slice. Here's a slice. There's a slice. Take a slice. Any slice. Which slice do you want? HUD button select. This one. HUD button start. Okay. Gibson Les Paul. Nice. Me too, man. Sweet. I wish I had a Gibson from like the 60s. That's my dream guitar. And custom now. I would custom everything. Custom pickups. I'd want a custom. I don't know. I would definitely custom it out. Okay, so I can just turn off the slices thing. Should be good to go now to export these safer web. What are you making a lot of promo for? Oh, how did the event go? It was really great, man. Yeah, let's see if I could say this in a different way because I've said it so many times. Going to Indie Cup was very insightful. It was very insightful to watch people play the game in person. And what was even more insightful was realizing what I was trying to explain to people that were playing the game. Like, I would watch someone get stuck and I'd be like, oh man, that person's stuck. I feel bad for them. I should tell them that pressing select will bring up their inventory where they could use the top hat. So I found myself wanting to explain things. I'm like, the game shouldn't have to do that. A person should be able to just pick up this game and play it. And without tutorials too, I don't like tutorials. So I would rather have a game that has no tutorials, but yet still is self-explanatory. So yeah, that was great. It was great to meet other indie developers, met a lot of cool people, met a lot of great people in the industry too, in the game development industry here in the San Francisco Bay Area and around here as well on the West Coast. And also almost won the $10,000 and did win the audience choice. So that was all goodness, and it was a great thing to go to. And I'm incredibly thankful that that event happened and that I was there. You got it in cream? Oh, yeah. You have a certificate of authenticity too? Oh, Scottish Pizza. Oh, that's so awesome. Dude. That's the guitar I wish I had too, man. Maybe a different color, but same kind of thing. That's awesome, man. Okay, so now we've got the select icon. Now we can go to game scene, and when we HUD HUD button, oh, HUD button. There we go. All right, so button select, HUD button select, HUD button start, start. Okay, cool, those are hooked up. Next. Here is where we want to put another kit sprite and another label. For the select button. Did you watch the extra credits episode about playtesting? No, I did not. I did not. I have not seen Extra Credits play testing video. I will check this out tonight. Anyways, you're right. They should know how to play the game without you telling them. Totally. Yeah, totally. Cool. Your dad's friend is in a band. Whoa. Oh, that's awesome. You released your first Android app today? Sweet. Nice. Oh, isn't that funny how projects do that? They balloon. Well, good for you. That's awesome. That's an amazing thing that you release something. For you as a fruit cologne with every purchase. Yeah, so for this input type, we want button select. We'll put this sprite at probably plus 38. I guess 38 is fine. And this one going to be zero. No. No, still one. Yeah, one. And then this font here, menu item inventory. P.x plus not just 38, but 38 plus 6 or 44. I think that should work. Let's see. Oh, it was a bad thing. Oh, yeah. Well, it's good that you realized that that was a bad thing that you ballooned your time, though. You know, so a lot of people never do that. They scope whatever, and then they make their game. And then they realize that it should have taken less time, but yet they don't really do anything about it. Most people never ever do anything about that. Okay, yeah, we got X for use. This is not very self-explanatory though, with that select icon. I guess it makes sense. Does that look like it? Would you guys say that that is the select button on an Xbox controller? I guess if you're looking at the Xbox controller, it makes sense. So yeah, I guess I'll keep it that way. Okay, so I just need to space them out a little bit better. It's labeled back though on the controller. It is. It is. Yeah, but I never say it's actually select in the game. I mean, I'm just saying use this button to go to your inventory. Okay. Well, I can always draw something else if it's not that self-explanatory. But for now, I just want to position these correctly. So the X position needs to go over a bit. The size dot width. I think size that width times a quarter, and all of that times pixel. Yeah. So swapping them because the back button is like back in the menu of options. All right. What I'm thinking actually, that's a good idea. But what I'm thinking is actually select and start should both bring up the start menu, or at least the start menu should be. It should be one menu. So right now there's two different menus. There's a select menu, which brings up the inventory. Start menu brings up the pause. That's how it was in the original Legend of Zelda, but I always thought that was confusing in the original Legend of Zelda. It's like, okay, wait, which one do I press? Select does that. Start does this. I think it would be better if they were one menu. But let me tell me your thoughts on that. Is that cool? So save and quit would basically just be an option on this menu somehow. Like maybe on the left side of the screen you had a bunch of different things, like you had inventory, and it would bring up this. You know, so there would be a slight menu inside this screen. Maybe it always shows your map, but then once you have to select inventory to get to these items, or maybe it starts off with the inventory and you can select different modes or something. I'm not sure. Yeah, it did. Yeah, so how did Ocarina of Time do it again? Oh, that's right. Did they use L and R to go to different sections or something? Oh, they had different buttons up here for return, save, decide. Yeah. Yeah, it looks like it from here. PMC, do I watch or play any sports? Not really. I'll watch football, American football, during the season. You know, I like soccer too. I like watching the World Cup sometimes. You know, I'll watch basketball. I'll watch any game of sports, but I'm not really going to follow them because I don't have time at all to follow sports. I only have time to make games. Yeah, so all right. Yeah, so Z and R got you to different sections of this. And then you could also, you got a few different buttons up here, which you could use. Yeah, so I'll do something like this, I'm thinking, where it's all one menu, so it's not confusing at all. And either one of the buttons you press, select or start, will bring up the menu. Okay. Do I think having the live chat on streams helps with tough decisions? Yes, it does, Scottish Pizza. From my perspective, streaming live, this is one of the most helpful things about live streaming is direct feedback. I get to actually ask you guys, what do you think? What do you prefer as a player? You know, I know what I prefer as a player, but it's great to have your guys' direct feedback on what you prefer as players. So okay, then so now the Xbox or the X button is a little bit more to the left. I could see that working, but maybe being a little bit less, a little bit tighter in. Do I think games, yeah, like League of Legends, Call of Duty should be considered a sport? Well, I like considering them an e-sport myself. You know, it's not like it's not really that physically demanding, but it really is in a way, you know? It's physically demanding in the sense that you have to have such good eye-hand coordination, such amazing amounts of practice, which basically just boils down to muscle memory. So yeah, I guess in general I do consider all those games a sport. And especially if you look at some of the top players of those games and how much time they have to spend to maintain their number one position, it's incredible. It's like a full-time job just to stay awesome at Call of Duty, you know, to be one of the top 10 players in the world at Call of Duty. They did a whole podcast about it. I heard about it through the grapevine or whatever. Yeah, I totally think that. I think that for sure. It should be a sport. Is chess a sport? Good question. Also along the same lines. Okay, so this needs to be like this. We grab the label first. And this can give us the width. Let's not even put the button just yet. Let's just do the label. And I want to do p.x minus... size dot width, not times a whole, but maybe times more like 0.2. Yeah. Oh, wait, one more thing. Oh. Ping pong and bowling are also considered sport. Makes sense? Yeah, that does make you an athlete. Does it? Does it? Oh, the debate? Oh, right. This one needs to be 0.5. Ah, all right. That's a good point, Eve. It depends on if you're playing professionally, right? When it becomes a competition. I guess they're both still sports, right? Okay, that is back to 1. Yeah, 0.5. I think that's right. All you guys do is bet. Does that make it your profession? Close. Getting close. Now it's just the... height of that button. So this here, what does that buzzing sound like? Happy birthday? The song he plays when you pick up an item? Whoops. How did I get it on the wrong side? This is minus and minus. Oh, Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. It is kind of. Is it the same notes? It might be the same notes. In fact, I think Twinkle Twinkle Little Star is in the key of C, and so is Jib. I can't read piano, but I think this is. Yeah, look at this. Oh, there's a G7. Is that the same thing as is that as G major? C. No, these are chords. Wait. So if it's on the line. Okay, some of these are black keys, some of these are white keys. Never mind. I don't know why that's the same sound. I'm pretty sure Jib is in the key of C, which is all major notes or non-minor, whatever. G7 is just F, yeah. Go to the YouTube video. I'll see. They are all whole notes. See, there you go. That's why, Tom. It's because Jib is the exact same notes. It's all the key of C. Would I ever consider working in a team to create a massive project like an MMO? Probably not. I've done it before. Prefer to do things on my own. Songbird should be an esport. Thanks, man. I like that. Okay, so this label, we want plus size, PLY, do. And then this one, label I get position plus 5 plus content size and then 0 there. See if these lines these buttons up more centered like. Yeah. Yeah, right? Especially if you can make a living doing it. Who wouldn't? Right, looks like I put the button on the wrong side again. And this one needs to go further over. This needs to be labeled at get position. Oh, yeah, minus minus. Yeah, it's funny to think Jib always talks in the key of C. But I wanted to have him to have some kind of consistent feeling. And you get that when you always use the same key. He always sounds happy. That's weird. Why didn't it put the button on top of the I there? It didn't measure this correctly. Nice. Pre-book some rehab. Oh, man. What did I do wrong here? This is supposed to be plus, minus, y, half. Maybe that's supposed to be. Oh, it's supposed to be one. Yeah. Nice, Scottish pizza. Thank you, man. Yeah, just wait till, I mean, it's gonna get a lot better over the coming months too. Especially once I drop in more dungeons, more enemies. And then finally, when I'm at the story, It's gonna be way better. Yes, finally, we have it. Kinda looking right. We got X to use. The little black button for the inventory. Okay, and let's force it to not have a button. So let's say it couldn't find the button that you were had equipped it to. What's up, QLav? Yeah, Boogie, totally. I let everybody at Indie Cup choose their own seed, do their own stuff, and luckily, no one found a broken world. That was awesome. I think the maze generator is a lot better these days. I mean, it's way harder to produce a broken world because there's more checks. It checks to make sure that all the paths are connected. It checks to make sure that A-star pathfinding can find every position on the map. So compared to the last release, this new maze generator is a lot better. I think that's why. You can't remember the first game you ever played? I can. The very first game I ever played, for you was Rayman, huh? For me it was Mario, the very first Super Mario Brothers. I saw that and I was like, wow, video game. Awesome. Well, it didn't quite align it correctly there. I wonder why. We already have a queue. Oh yeah, there's a queue. Mario to you for you too. Awesome. Yeah, so it was Mario the first game I ever played, but Zelda was the first game I ever fell in love with. I was like, wow, this game's definitely my speed. All right, I'm just gonna cheat a little bit here and do q.x plus equals 10 or whatever. And that's if there's no equip index, it just adds a little bit. Yeah, now it's centered. This is great. Little subtle indicator to the player what to do when you get a new item. And most of the time, it's going to function like this, where it knows what item it's equipped to. All right, we're getting close to this being done. I love the new size for the buttons. I love the select start buttons. Awesome. Yeah, in fact, all these need to be to the left a little. Whoa. You can do it, man. All you got to do is get in your meditative zone. You'll remember. In fact, you'll probably remember tonight while you're dreaming or next time you're totally relaxing. You'll be like, oh, I remember now. It was Ninja Gaiden. There we go. Yeah, now they're centered. It's looking good. Got X to use it. Let's see if X even works. Yep. X is the button for sure. Sweet. Oh, thanks, man. Nice. Thanks, Scottish Pizza. I really appreciate you saying that, man. Yeah, it's really nice to hear that, too, because it just reminds me I'm on the right track. But I really appreciate that, man. And also, you know, I really hope that what I'm doing helps you guys, you know, whether you want to make games or maybe you don't, maybe you're just interested in how games are made or maybe you're interested in this game, whatever. I'm just stoked that I can kind of be a help to the world, an inspiration or a sort of like a guide. I wish I was some cool spirit guide though. It would come in like, I was like Yoda or something. That'd be great. Okay, we got these buttons working. Next thing, I wanted to show the keyboard keys that you would use. So, like for example, when you're in the game here, it's gonna show the keys that I have bound to the items when I'm using the keyboard. So I'm running around, I'm using the keyboard. It should, instead of saying A, B, X, Y on the bottom, it should show the keys I use, which are F, D, S, and G. Okay, so that's going to require a map of keyboard codes to letters. So we're going to need a words for that. Okay, wait, I got a question for you guys. On international keyboards, right? If you're on, say you're in a different country besides, you know, using the English language, are the letters on the keyboard, does it matter if they're not exactly right for you? Like for example, S, the letter S or A. I know A has lots of different, I guess this is gonna need to be localized, huh? Because, so, you know, if this were China or Japan or Korea, your keyboard does not have any Western letters on it. So, yeah, this needs to be totally localized as well. Okay, this is going to be a lot of work, but it needs to be done. Whew. Okay, let's do this. Wait, so that means it doesn't need to be part of constants. It could just be part of the data. Okay, so never mind. This is not going to be as much work as I thought. Oh no, 2D game dev, you feel like you're going to make him mad? Oh, right on. Nice, right on. So what's the Elder Scrolls part? I haven't played Elder Scrolls. Don't throw tomatoes at me. Yeah, but I really haven't played Elder Scrolls. So wait, in like strings, English, We're gonna need a whole list of buttons. So key A, for example, it's just gonna be A for us, for in America and UK, Canada, and all the other countries that use English. Key one, for example, is gonna be one. But in other countries, this might be different. Your one key might be something totally else. So at least I have this localized. Throw potatoes. Oh, those hurt. All right. Keyboard codes. I need to look up all these keyboard codes. Input.cpp is where it uses some of these. Keyboard key code, here it is. All right, here we go. We need to I need to do pretty much all of these need some kind of letter. Oh. All right, so I'm going to replace all the key underscores with key space space. Yeah, I've heard of them. Totally heard of them. Oh, so it's open world. It's like an open world RPG, right? It's not an MMO, right? It's like an actual single player RPG. Is that correct? Get rid of these commas. Oh, okay. Cool. So those regular ones you're talking about are not MMOs, but they do have their own MMO. Are there any unique, totally unique concepts in Elder Scrolls that are different than all other RPGs? Or is there something that just makes them really, really very Elder Scrolls-y? Okay, so none, we don't need that. Key pause. Scroll lock. I think some of these keys can just be blank. I guess we can have scroll lock. Oh man, I do need to do a whole two different arrays for all these, but oh well. This has to be done. So I have a lookup array, right? So the actual keyboard button key underscore pause needs to map to this, which then gets looked up into this actual text. Dragon shouts, huh? Right. Just the amount of story and lore. Cool. Oh, state off games? Isn't there a concept like scan codes versus key codes like in SDL? No. Not here in Cocos 3DX. So I need to do this to localize this. I need to have a couple different this is just purely for localization. That's the only reason I have to do all this. until I took an arrow to the knee. You'll play using your Windows keys. All right, Windows. The Windows button has to be supported. All right, I better get typing because this is going to take a while. Break. Escape. Back. Back is key escape. We don't need that one. Backspace. Back tab? What's back tab? Do we need this? Return. Hell, you know what? Instead of doing all this right now, I think I'll just do it inside the code to hook up the button that you would use. So let's do that. This fun code first. Nice. They're super detailed, huh? Okay. I can finish that data here in a second, but for now, I think I can make it pretty easy and just say, if it's a letter key, I can just use the letter. So, okay, I want the A, the B, the X, and the Y at the bottom to be keys that I have bound. That's in game scene. In set input type. It applies all the images. If it's keyboard, here, let's just mess with this really quick. We'll set the string for this. To be A plus I. So it's just gonna go A, B, C, D. Oops, no, that shouldn't be A plus I, it should be. Damn, we need to make a string out of that. There. Whoa, you have 1,000 hours on it? Wow. Yeah, A, B, C, D. Yes. Got the right stuff. So all it's got to do here is map those right based on your keys you're using. So what? So I need to look up the keys you're using. Which is gonna be bindings. I need to look up the bindings. 600 hours on Oblivion. Whoa, Vassalori. Wow. So it would be something like gate bindings. Oh. It was only gate binding, that's right. How do I do this gate binding thing just right? I need to pass in a UN32 code. It looks it up and returns the binding if it has it. Oh, the code. Oh yeah, the code is just the keyboard code. Wait, no, is it? Whoa. Man. Sounds like it was a really epic game, huh? I guess I need to play Skyrim. Sounds like I need to play the first one first, huh? Is that true? Or should I get Oblivion or Morrowind first? Get Binding. Set button down. Touch began. Touch ended. Key press. Here it is. Yeah, so it is the unsigned code, the keyboard code. All right. Whoa, it's only $9? Cool, I should get it. Nice. So it's moddable too. So which one should I start with? Skyrim, Oblivion, or Morrowind? I guess I'm just gonna start with Skyrim by default, because I always like starting at the beginning. Yeah, totally. I'm definitely on that side. It really doesn't matter how great graphics are in a game to me. As long as the story is awesome, the gameplay is awesome. All right, Skyrim it is. Sweet. Okay, I gotta put Skyrim on my list. You can get it on Steam, right? Let's see if I'm still logged in. Oh, there's a lot of Skyrims. Is it this one? Nice. This is great. I can check this out a little bit later too. Oh, so you can start with any of them, huh? Okay. Needs to be like a reverse input lookup. I don't think I've written this yet, where I would take like a certain button and find whatever binding was for that, because it works the other way around usually. Yeah, I don't think I've written this yet. Right. So I guess it could return an array. CocoaCDX has a built-in? What are you talking about? Really? Do I not have to do all this work? GLFOW has scan codes, huh? Wow, thanks, Sadoff Games. Did I get to the same loop? Same. Yeah, I got the same link. All right, cool. Thanks, man. Oh my God, who's blowing up my phone right now? Oh, thanks, man. Burp, burp, burp. The scan code of a key is specific to that platform. Sometimes even to that machine. That's not what I want to use then. Scan codes are intended to allow users to bind keys that don't have a GLFW key token. Such keys have key set to GLFW key unknown. Oh, so I don't need that then. Oh, okay. I don't need that at all. I'm just looking to scan codes represent the physical position of the keys modeled after. Oh, physical position of the keys. While key codes are the character obtained by pressing the key. Oh, okay. Yeah, I think I'm already using scan codes. Yeah, CocoStudioX is already using scan codes with its event keyboard. And now I'm just localizing it. So yeah, I think I've already got that. Have you ever used Unity to make a game? Yes, I have. I would definitely recommend it. Yes. Yeah, I would definitely continue using it, especially if you're already kind of familiar with it. Just keep going with it. Keep getting whatever engine you want to use, just get familiar with it. That's my only recommendation. It doesn't really matter that much whether you're using Unity or Game Maker or CocoStudioX or whatever, as long as you're familiar with it. If you're familiar with it and you're comfortable doing little things like adding a sprite or getting input or playing a sound, little things like that, that matters more than almost, you know, the engine. Because today's engines are all pretty much really good. They're all, just about all of them are cross-platform, which is really important to have in an engine. And, you know, as long as it has the whatever features you want, then, dude, you're good to go. So, yeah, just get familiar with it, man. And it's not going to hurt you. You know, if you're learning Unity, it's not going to be something that you're going to throw out the window one day and be like, ah, I'm so disappointed that I spent that time learning Unity. You know, because it will probably be something you use. So, Rocket Bunny, what's up, man? Merry Christmas. Happy Hanukkah. Happy holidays. Happy all of them. Dude, should I turn my phone off? What's up? Somebody's texting me like somebody's winning the Super Bowl right now. Okay, I need a function that is a reverse lookup that takes a code and gives me. No, it takes the button index and gives me back a code. All right, let's write it. Jeez. I guarantee you it's not important. How was yesterday's stream? It was great, man. Yeah. I guarantee you, are the Ducks on? Are the Oregon Ducks on?
It's my friends. I thought it was my dad.
Okay, so reverse lookup of reverse binding lookup, basically. Static. This gives me an int UN32 code. Get code given a binding type. Oh, actually, it needs to fill up a vector of codes. They're not dying. They're all right. They're all right. Will you be streaming anytime close to Christmas? Yeah, of course. Yeah, I will. Oh, nice, man. Thanks, Scottish Pizza. Could I do an all-day Christmas Eve stream? Probably not. That's some time that I want to be wanting to spend with my lady doing some Christmas Eve-y stuff. But, you know, maybe one of those days around there I could... I'm not going to commit to that. Not yet. You guys have been trying to get me to do all-day streams and 24-hour streams, and I think in the future I will at some point. But at this point, I can't say when. Get the code for a given binding. I'll get the codes for a given binding. Yeah. Commit. You should commit. Just do it. Oops. I don't need in.h. If you say you can, you can. School's out in 2 days? Yes. Yay. All right, so if anybody just joined the stream, let me do a little reminder of where I'm at, what I'm doing here in a second. It'll finish compiling here in a sec. Yeah. I know, it's so early, right? When I was a kid, we got out on Christmas Eve. Joking. Yeah, Boogie and I are both bitter. We're bitter. We only had like 3 days off. We had to walk home in the snow. All right, so we don't need that. Okay, so you'll recap of where we're at here. Had woo suck. Oh, that would suck. So when I was a kid, my grandpa always told me stories. He's like, yeah, when I was your age, we had to walk uphill both ways. We had to walk through the snow on the way there and the snow on the way back. You know, it was always like the hardest stuff. I don't know if you guys have that kind of story over in your neck of the woods. Okay, so basically what I'm working on here is some stuff to make it clearer for using your input. So right now I'm using the Xbox controller. And it switched to using Xbox icons. And if I switch to using the keyboard, it switches to keyboard letters. Same thing if I go back to the Xbox controller. And when I pick up an item, it shows me a quick little explanation. One is what button to use that item that you just obtained. And the other thing is how to get to the freaking inventory, which is really important. So that's all it is. It's just the game should be self-explanatory. That's the whole point of yesterday's stream and today's stream. So now I'm working on some code that will make it so when I'm using the keys on the keyboard, it will actually show me the key that's on the keyboard instead of ABCD or ABXY. So, and it's taking a while because this is actually quite complicated. I gotta convert the keyboard code to a lookup into the localized strings and then load the localized string for whatever keyboard somebody's using. This could be played in Korea and there'd be a totally different icon for their key. How does that work? Uphill one way and then uphill back? I know, it doesn't make sense at all. Yeah, Scottish Pizza, nice. Thanks, Eve. Me too. Thanks. Nice. Do they allow games in Korea? I don't know. Dude, the school slides down the hill and past the house while you're inside. That's totally it. That's that. Oh, now I realize what my grandpa meant all these years. Okay, so I'm gonna loop over all the bindings. Thanks, Eve. The one is plays games. All right, man, I'll show you the game. Hold on a second. Let me X that out. I'll do a little brief play for anybody that hasn't seen the game. How am I doing on time? Oh, it looks like that's going to be the end of the stream anyways. Okay, so I'll play the game a little bit, and that'll be it for today. And it looks like I'll have to finish up this keyboard stuff later on tonight. Okay, so I'm going to play with my Xbox controller, but you can play with any kind of controller. This game's coming out for Windows, Mac, Linux. I was stuck in this world because I couldn't bomb there. Yeah, Windows, Mac, Linux, it's coming out sometime in 2016. This game's called Songbringer. I've already got a few items. I have the sword, I have the top hat. Oh, I have my map, I have bombs. Let's map that, let's map this. Okay, so I'm gonna use That was the compass. It shows you where the first level is on this. Oh, well, I'm way up there. Anyways, I'll play around a little bit. There's an overworld to this game, and there's like lots and lots of dungeons. You didn't finish your Ludum Dare game? Are you gonna finish it? Check this out. State of games. Oh, these guys. There'll be some kind of secret item, I'm sure, if I get all these guys. Set off a bomb right there and found this secret area. So cool. What's this? Diamonds! Give me them all! Yeah, 125? That's a big one. Oh, you scoped too high? So wait, you're probably gonna finish it. Alright. Stayed off. Stayed off games is your father? That's like a different account. That's cool. Do your father makes father's on Twitch too? Let's see if I can find a level. All right, so where are we at? There. Oh, I don't. It doesn't show you on the map where levels are, but let's see if we can find a level so I can show you what that looks like. Oh, can't get behind this waterfall. Nothing back there. Oh. Duck! Ah, these guys are hard. Run away! So this is a procedurally generated game. It's a lot like Zelda 1. That's the main inspiration for this game. The big difference between this and Zelda 1 is that it's procedurally generated. So every single tile of this whole game comes from six letters that you give it when you start the game. So your six letters are like a seed. That seed generates an entire world. The world becomes what you play. So every time you play it, you can play a different world if you want, or you can play some world that you already know just by entering the same seed. So it's like as if Zelda 1 could be a different adventure every time. Yeah, Scottish pizza, good point, right? Even that you started a Ludum Dare is cool. Good job, Rocket Bunny. And even if you don't finish your game, I still want to see what you started, dude. Nice, thanks, man. Yeah, so I'm trying to find a level to show you guys, but I don't know where the levels are in this world, because I changed the algorithm this morning again. Little bit. I made one little refinement to the algorithm, which basically every time I oh, here we go. Here's a level. Which one is this? Level 6. It's always level 6. It's always some really hard level. At the beginning of the game. Oh, crashed it. Why'd we crash? Create water tile? I was just messing with this code this morning. I wonder what I messed up there. Water tile. Maybe this doesn't have a sprite. Oh, it could be that. Yeah, it just could be that this doesn't even have a sprite. Okay, I think I can fix this pretty quick. If I, oh. Check the render component, basically. If. Now, we'll put it here. If render does it. If it isn't empty. All right, see you, Eve. Later, man. Always check if no, for sure, Lime. What's up, Lime? Wait, it was this room that I went into, right? And all of a sudden, the water was messing it up, crashing. Yeah, I think it was that room, wasn't it? Or was it this one? Yeah, no. Okay, so let's confirm that actually fixed the bug. And it wasn't something totally random. So if I comment that back out, run it again, go into that same room, it should crash again. If it doesn't, then that was something weird. Oh, good. I'm so glad it crashed again. Okay, so yeah, I don't know why it's creating a water tile. Like, oh, because it's just a tile. Oh, because this. It's the room below. It's grabbing one of the tiles. So it's not checking. Oh, it is checking valid pause. There's no water. It's so weird. There's no water in this area, but yet it's crashing. Yes, yeah, still working on inputs. Yep. So one good thing is check it out. When I start using the Xbox controller, it shows me the Xbox controller buttons down here in the HUD. And also, when you get a new item, it shows you the button that you need to use, and also the button you need to use to get into the inventory. So that's coming along really good. Now I'm working on the next thing I'll work on tonight. I'm about done with the stream right now. Is to get the when I'm using keyboard, like if I touch the keyboard keys, it'll switch to showing keyboard buttons down there. I want those to be the actual keyboard buttons. So there's a lot of work to get that finished because it has to be localized. Oh, you know what? Oh, I know what it is. There's no water tile in the world. I just did this morning to make water. Data driven, so I can go to cave. Caves should be able to have water. Stone levels should be able to have water. Everything should be able to have water. Water is super important. There we go. Okay, so now it should have water on this screen. Yeah, totally live a button updating. Still no water. Oh, wait, there is water, but it's not here. It definitely drew to the reflection mask as well. And I can see where it's got water. Let's see. So that red area is where the water is. Oh, see, the water is underneath. Somehow got put underneath the ground. So water inside the dungeon stone. I think it needs a Z offset plus 4. Yes. Reflections without water, right? What's with that? Nope. This is the right. Oh, it could be using a different. Oh, let's just try a whole bunch. Plus 9. Hey, dude, thanks, Scottish Pizza. Oh, that's awesome. Man, I really appreciate that. Oh, this is a really curious problem. Oh, you know what? It could be, it could be this other bit of code in, area creation where it does this here. I think that was 997 before. Just go 1,000. Just add them all. I think it was here. There's something. I'm not sure why this is that way. I need to check this out some more. Yeah, that was the problem. Okay. Cool. Glad I got that solved because that was super important. Water, just like Live Studio said, water is essential to life. Yep, so that's Songbringer. And it's really, really primordial at this point. There's a lot of stuff to add to this game. It's got a lot more to go. Yeah, Scottish Pizza and everybody else too. I know a lot of you people out there. There's people that are not even chatting right now that watch this game on YouTube sometimes. And I'm sure there's people there that have shared with their friends too. And to everybody that shares this game with your friends, everybody that's even interested in this game, I extend my humble gratitude. I really appreciate it. Because I'm one dude. One dude, it's hard to spread the word. So thank you for spreading the word. Yep, okay, so that's it for today's stream. I'll work more on the input tonight. And that ought to be finished up, and then tomorrow I'll be working on something else. One of the things I'm working on right now is making everything in the world a lot more data-driven. Oh, it equipped the key. There's a bug. It equipped the password is not equipable. It's a passive item, so I need to work on that. So I took a screenshot to remember that. Yeah. Bye, you guys. See ya. Cool. Have a good night. We'll check you next time.